the directors and the auditors report, a letter to the shareholders, and management and discussion analysis have already been circulated to you. With your permission, I would like to take them as read. Dear shareholders, in the golden decade of Reliance, I am proud to inform you that it was yet another year of robust and record performance. Last year, Reliance became India's largest and most profitable company, both in the public and the private sectors. We are the only diversified, multi-sector Indian enterprise with three major growth engines in one single corporate entity: our oil to chemicals division, Jio, and retail. All three have done exceedingly well in the past year. We are also incubating new growth engines within Reliance. Skeptics used to say that Reliance cannot succeed in a consumer business. Jio and Reliance Retail have proved them wrong. If these two consumer businesses had been separately listed companies, each would be ranked among the top 10 in India in terms of value. Jio crossed the 340 million subscriber mark to remain the world's fastest growing digital services company. Today, Jio is India's largest telecom enterprise in terms of subscribers, revenues, and profits. Jio has truly become the digital gateway of India. Reliance Retail has crossed ₹130,000 crore turnover to cement its position as India's largest retailer. It is four times larger than the second largest retail player, and it is larger than all other major retailers put together. Our two consumer businesses now collectively contribute nearly 32% to the consolidated EBITDA, up from 2% 5 years ago. The day is not far when their share would be 50% of our overall EBITDA. The third growth engine is our oils to chemicals business. Let me now highlight Reliance's record contribution to the Indian economy in the last year. We continue to be India's largest exporter at ₹2,24,391 crores, and with exports to over 107 countries, accounting for 9.8% of India's total merchandise export. We continue to be the highest payer of customs and excise duty in the private sector at ₹26,379 crores last year. We also continue to be the highest payer of GST amongst all public and private sector companies at ₹67,320 crores last year. We were also the highest payer of income tax in the private sector at 12,191 crores. Dear shareholders, the coming year will mark the beginning of the most ambitious value creation strategy in the history of Reliance and in the history of India. At the heart of our new value creation strategy is our innovative philosophy of transforming relationships into partnerships. Partnerships with leading global and Indian companies. Partnerships with millions of local businesses, SMEs, and micro enterprises across India. Partnerships with new tech-enabled businesses, platforms, and social enterprises. All these partnerships will form a new business coalition capable of creating exponential value for our five stakeholders: the Indian economy, the Indian people, our customers, employees, and shareholders. Dear shareholders, the future of India and also the future of Reliance has never looked brighter to me than now. As India is getting transformed into a new India, Reliance will transform itself into a new Reliance. Our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, has set the goal of making India a $5 trillion economy by 2024. I fully endorse this ambitious goal. Indeed, I can clearly see India becoming a $10 trillion economy by 2030, with every Indian as a beneficiary. This is achievable, this is necessary, and this, I believe, is inevitable. I say this because digital-driven GDP growth is not only exponential, but also can be inclusive. Reliance's own value creation strategy will prove this. The slowdown in some sectors of the economy is temporary. The fundamentals of the Indian economy are very strong. The opportunities will grow further with structural reforms. India has political stability. The government is laying the foundation of new institutions for business promotion and regulation. New long-term measures are being taken to improve ease of living for all citizens and reduce income inequity. India is rising. No power on earth can stop India from rising higher. Dear shareowners, let me focus on Reliance's most valuable business today, the O2C division. Our oil to chemicals division is formed by combining our petrochemicals and refining business. Reliance has the most complex and integrated oil to chemicals business globally. Our oil to chemicals business has the ability to convert oil into high value chemicals and performance materials that will significantly improve the quality of life of Indians. As the world moves towards renewable energy sources and electrical vehicles, Reliance has positioned itself far ahead of the curve to create new value. Our oil to chemicals business achieved a revenue of rupees 5.7 lakh crores, exports of 2.2 lakh crores, and EBITDA of 52,041 crores. Reliance and BP signed a joint venture agreement in petroleum retailing business. In this initiative, BP is acquiring 49% stake in our petro retail business. Reliance will get 7,000 crores from BP for this transaction. My dear shareholders, I am now delighted to make an announcement about the biggest foreign investment in the history of Reliance. It is also amongst the largest foreign investments ever in India. Saudi Aramco and Reliance have agreed to form a long-term partnership in our oil to chemicals division. In terms of the understanding between the parties, Saudi Aramco will invest in Reliance for a 20% stake in our oil to chemicals division at an enterprise value of $75 billion or over 5.3 lakh crore. This investment by Saudi Aramco is subject to due diligence, definitive agreements, regulatory and other customary approvals. This partnership will cover all of Reliance's refining and petrochemical assets, including its 51% stake in the petroleum retail JV. Saudi Aramco will also supply 500,000 barrels a day of crude oil on a long-term basis to RIL's Jamnagar refinery. This signifies perfect synergy between the world's largest oil producer and the world's largest integrated refinery and petrochemicals complex. Since its inception, our Jamnagar refinery has been processing Saudi oil every single day for 20 years. Now we have transformed our long-standing relationship of two decades based on mutual trust into a partnership with tremendous growth potential. I feel privileged to welcome Saudi Aramco, which is the largest business enterprise in the world, to India. I am grateful to our visionary leaders, our own Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi and His Royal Highness Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman Al Saud, who have laid the foundation for strategic cooperation between India and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Dear shareholders, I am happy that our natural gas business will soon regain its place of pride in Reliance's value creation strategy. With Reliance de-emphasizing its shale gas business in the US, we are currently focused only on India. In our coal-based methane blocks, we are focusing on augmenting production. The joint venture with BP will play a major role as a producer of natural gas. With world-class deep water infrastructure in the east coast of India, our JV is uniquely positioned to monetize over 3 trillion cubic feet of discovered gas resources in the KGD6 block. Our JV has committed an investment of rupees 35,000 crores in the 3 deep water fields in this block. The project to develop these gas fields are amongst the most complex being executed anywhere in the world. This will commence production from the first half of 2020, with an expected peak production of 1 billion cubic feet per day, which is equivalent to nearly 30% of India's current indigenous gas production. The JV will emerge as a major contributor to India's energy security. Dear friends, now I turn to the youngest member of the Reliance family, Jio. India is today a $2.5 trillion economy. Statistics from large economies show that nearly 3 to 5% of their GDP is spent on digital services. Even at 3%, this translates to a potential Indian digital services spend of nearly 5 lakh crores annually. And I believe that Jio is ideally placed to earn a significant proportion of this technology-driven value addition to our economy. Friends, Jio was founded with the vision to bring digital life to every Indian. And this vision was built on two pillars. The first was digital connectivity, where Jio would connect everyone, every place, and everything with the highest quality and affordability. And the second was to build digital platforms and solutions built to suit the unique requirements of India and Indians, spanning all walks of life, like entertainment, e-commerce, financial services, education, healthcare, agriculture, e-governance, and everything beyond. Let me begin with digital connectivity. On 5th September this year, Jio turns 3 years old. And what an incredible 3 years it has been. In the sacred Upanishads, we have the famous mantra, Tamaso Ma Jyotir Gamaya, which means lead us from darkness to light. In a manner of speaking, before Jio, India was data dark. And now, Jio has made India data shining bright. Friends, today, Jio's customer base has crossed 340 million users, and still we are signing up more than 10 million new customers every month. The potential for growth is immense, and 500 million customers is now, I believe, well within our reach. On behalf of the entire Jio family, thank you, India, for the enormous trust that you have placed in us. Thank you, India, again, from the bottom of my heart. Because of you, India, because of you, Jio has not only become the largest operator in India, but also the second largest operator in the world in a single country. Dear shareholders, your company has invested nearly 3.5 lakh crores towards creating a state-of-the-art digital infrastructure across India, with largest optical fiber footprint. And recently, we have divested about 1.25 lakh crores of hard infrastructure into separate infrastructure investment trusts, or INVITs, to better monetize and unlock value from these assets. Through these investments, we have created world-class, legacy-free, future-proof assets, all of which are fixed mobile converged. The core and the aggregation layers of our converged network are already 5G ready today. And because of our early adoption of ongoing enhancements to LTE technology, our wireless network is already 4G plus, and we can upgrade this to 5G at minimum incremental cost. Thanks to Jio's converged network architecture, we can offer even faster fixed broadband to homes and business establishments today. Friends, unlike other industry players, your company has had the foresight to pre-invest in network assets. For this reason, I can report to you today that the investment cycle of Jio is now complete. Only marginal investments in access are now required to grow capacity to meet the growing demand. This gives us tremendous operating leverage and superior returns on our investment for years to come. Friends, while most of our investments are complete, we have so far fired up just one of the engines of revenue generation for Jio, namely mobile broadband. Even with one engine, Jio has been profitable from its first quarter of commercial operations. And now we are ready to kickstart four more engines of connectivity revenue for Jio. And they are, first, Internet of Things, or IoT, for all over India. Second, home broadband services. Third, enterprise broadband services. And fourth, broadband for small and medium businesses. And I'm glad to report that the revenues from each of these engines will kick in within this financial year itself. Let me now describe these new growth engines. First, Internet of Things. Jio has developed an innovative service on its pan-India 4G network called Narrowband Internet of Things, or NB-IoT. Using NB-IoT, data from billions of smart sensors, whether residential, industrial, or public, can be collected from across India with the highest reliability and lowest cost. To take just one example, there are over 300 million electricity meters which need to be connected digitally for real-time monitoring and for giving consumers full visibility and control of cost and quality. And going forward, each home and business premise will have dozens of connected devices. Within another 2 years, it is estimated that there will be more than 2 billion connected IoT devices in our country. Jio aims to connect at least 1 billion of these on Jio's IoT platform, and this translates into a 20,000 crore per year revenue opportunity for Jio. Jio's IoT platform will be commercially available starting 1st January 2020. Now the second engine, home broadband. Last year, I had shared with you Jio's plan for optical fiber fixed line broadband service called Jio Fiber. Starting August 15th of last year, we invited registrations of interest from across India so that we could prioritize Jio Fiber rollout into localities with the highest interest. The response was simply overwhelming. We received over 15 million registrations from nearly 1,600 towns. And based on these registrations, we have drawn up a plan to reach 20 million residences and 15 million business establishments in these 1,600 towns. Over the past year, we have built significant momentum in our Jio Fiber rollout, and we are confident that we will complete our network rollout within the next 12 months. During the last year, we also installed Jio Fiber on a trial basis in nearly 500,000 homes, that is 5 lakh homes, to fine-tune our services and, based on actual customer feedback, improve our services. And we have found that these trial homes, on an average, are consuming more than 100 GBs per month. And this usage is increasing with each passing day. Friends, with Jio Fiber, you get lightning-fast broadband speeds of up to 1 Gbps. You get a landline phone connection at no additional cost. You get a digital set-top box that opens up unparalleled digital experiences within your home. Ultra-high-definition entertainment, virtual reality content, multi-party video conferencing, voice-enabled virtual assistants, interactive gaming, home security, and many other smart home solutions. The digital possibilities are endless. And then there is television, which is still at the heart of the Indian home. Television service in India is a classic small business success story where local cable operators or LCOs played a pioneering role. In recent years, competition from DTH operators have threatened the viability of nearly 1 lakh LCOs who still operate across India. As firm supporters of local and small businesses, Jio wanted to ensure that these LCOs continue to serve their communities. Earlier this year, RIL acquired controlling stakes in 3 leading cable MSOs, Hathway, Den, and GTPL, who have direct relationship with over 30,000 LCOs. Over the past months, we have worked with our MSOs to upgrade their infrastructure to world-class standards. After these upgrades, our LCO partners will now be able to offer the largest bouquet of high-definition channels to customers with better features, reliability, and customer experience, better even than DTH. But now we have gone one step further. We have designed a Jio set-top box to accept the broadcast cable TV signals from our LCO partners so that from now, every Jio fiber home, our LCO partners will have access and will continue to have a steady stream of revenue for their broadcast TV business. We look forward to extending this partnership to all the local cable operators across the country. Next, for small and medium businesses, Jio Fiber enables a powerful combination of fixed line connectivity and cloud applications, leapfrogging them from no technology to having a complete lineup of cutting edge plug and play technology enabled tools. This will make them productive from day one and empower them to succeed in the marketplace, even against much larger enterprises. I believe that in their success lies the recipe for sustainable growth and large-scale employment for the Indian economy. And finally, large enterprises. In the past, enterprises had no choice but to make large expenditures of time, money, and effort to keep pace with technology. Today, cloud-based solutions provide out-of-the-box capabilities which are easier, faster and cheaper to adopt. Jio Fiber and Jio's cloud solutions level the playing field for Indian enterprises, enabling them to accelerate their digital transformation and compete globally using the very same technologies that are used by global majors. Friends, I now want to invite Isha, Akash, and Kiran on the stage to demonstrate some of the game-changing features of Jio Fiber.